When you were arrested on Monday and brought in, were you told why you were under arrest?
Absolutely not.
No.
You had no idea?
No.
No. Not for 48, maybe 36 to 48 hours later.
Pedro, when did you become aware?
Well, there was an inmate that didn't speak English, so I translated for her. So then I asked her, now that I help you, can you help me?
This is to the officer.
Yes.
Said.
And she said, sure. What you want to know? I want to know what am I being charged for? So she said, okay, I go see. So she comes back and she's got a piece of paper written down whatever I was in for. And because I don't have my reading glasses, I looked and I said, oh, open containers. She said, no, read it again. And I said, oh, kidnapping? What's this, kidnapping?
Where was Ariel?
Ariel was in the front, toward the front on suicide watch.
Did he ever go past you? Did you ever see him or?
I did. Because in where he was at, there's no toilet. So across the from my cell, there was one open. So he came there, used it. That's when I seen him. And when he came out, he said peace to me.
So evidently that happened with him over there. And when he walked past me, he goes, O'Neill, you're never going to see me again. I love you, bro. And that was it.
So when did you become aware of what he did?
Well, just shortly after that, when the detective took me into the room and started asking me questions and showing me pictures of the girls. And when he showed me the pictures of the girls, asked me, do you know these girls you showed me first? I can't tell you which one he showed me first, but he says, have you ever seen this girl? And I said, no, I've never seen that girl. And then he showed me the other one, have you ever seen this girl? I said, no, I have never seen that girl. And he says, that's Gina DeJesus and Amanda Berry. And my heart felt, I just dropped, not physically, but I just hit the ground. And after he said, that's Amanda Berry, and they were in your brother's house.
You had been to the house. You would go to the house.
Yes.
I mean, how often?
No, not how often. I didn't go to his house very much. But when I did, he would let me in, past the kitchen.
Could you see anything beyond the kitchen?
No. Because there's curtains.
He had the house blocked off with curtains.
Mm-hmm.
And what about, could you hear anything in the home?
No, the radio was playing all the time.
He would play music all the time?
Yeah. If not the radio, the TV. Something had to be on at all time in the kitchen. So I couldn't hear nothing else but the radio or the TV.
Did you in any way know, help, assist your brother in the horrible things he's accused of doing?
Absolutely not. No idea that this horrific crime was going on.
Pedro?
No.
You know there are people who will say you had to know. How is it possible for so long in that home, your brother, you couldn't know?
For those people out there, I'm gonna tell you something. I had nothing to do with this, and I don't know how my brother got away with it for so many years, because that would never cross my mind.
He fooled you.
He fooled me.
Do you worry now that people will always suspect that you actually did have a role?
Absolutely.
Yes.
And the people out there that know me, they know that Onil Castro is not that person, has nothing to do with that.
Same. I couldn't never think of doing anything like that.
What is your brother to you now?
A monster, a hateful. I hope he rots in that jail. I don't even want them to take his life like that. I want him to suffer in that jail to the last extent. I don't care if we even feed him what he has done to my life and my family's.
I feel the same way.
To the both of you now, he no longer exists. He
is, right.
Yeah.
He is gone.
He's goner.
Almost as if he were dead.
Yeah. The monster's a goner.
If you could talk to Gina, if you could talk to Michelle, if you could talk to Amanda, and in a way you are, I guess, what would you say?
I would tell them that I'm sorry that you had to go through this, that I was thinking about these girls being missing, and I'm just grateful that they're home and you know, out of that horrible house, and I just tell them that I'm sorry for what Ariel done. 'Cause see, not much. It's Felix. I know him for a long time, and when I found out that Ariel had Gina, I just broke down. 'Cause it's shocking. Ariel, we know this guy for a long time, Felix.
This is Gina's father.
Yeah, Felix, the head. Yes. And you got his daughter, and you go around like if nothing. You even went to the vigils. You hang posters. You give his mama a hug. And you got his daughter captive.
O'Neill, the same thing. I mean, if you
absolutely the same thing. I just want the families to get the one justice for the fullest extent. To the fullest extent, this has torn my heart apart. This has killed me. I am a walking corpse right now.
Why are you talking to me?
I want the world to know that O'Neill and Pedro, had nothing to do with death. It was a shock to me to learn that my brother Ariel was doing this.
Well, I want to thank you both for talking to us and for sharing with us and opening up to us. Thank you.
Thank you. And I hope the world listened to us. And
we want it back to normal.
You already got your monster. Please give us our freedom.